Hello, I'm Melanie, and today I tell you the concepts that Securosys has to support you building your PKI infrastructure. So the first concept is that you have an all-in-one cluster. So what is a cluster? You have multiple HSMs that are synchronized together in one bundle. It can be all over the world, geo-redundantly. And for the application, they all look the same. So the application can pick the nearest one to have the least network delay. If you want to have an all-in-one cluster, you have the possibility for multi-tenancy. So you have separate partition on each device. So you can separate your root key store or your issuing CR or customer provisioning. With multi-tenancy, each partition has other credentials and it can have other capabilities. So each partition, you have a different behavior and that you can configure in the partition configuration. For example, you can take a partition offline, but the other partitions are still online. You could say you want to allow key export or not. You can enable different APIs on each partition. And with that, you have full flexibility to configure each use case exactly as you wanted to. And each partition has different credentials. So one application is only able to log in to the according partition. Additionally, if you want to, you could set up a role that is managing only this partition. For example, for the root key store, you could define a group of people where you have 2 out of n to change that settings or to change the credentials or to get the logs and so on. For that, you can use our normal Decanus, that's the remote management device with a touch screen, but you can use it as a partition manager and onboard these people with their cards. So you have two-factor authentication, card and PIN, and you need 2 out of n people to then manage this partition. Especially we use that in our cloud service where we have a cluster and different customer own a partition. And some customer wants to take over the management of their partition with the partition Decanus device. So in our cloud service, we have different customers. Some have more than one partition and they are all synchronized within the cluster and the customers can just use a partition they want. And in that case, you have cheaper HSM service because you don't have to run the complete infrastructure. You can just rent a partition for as long as you need it, but you don't own the hardware. A completely different concept is the proof of key origin. So why did you do that? Normally, with a PKI application, you have a root key ceremony, which is quite a heavy task because you have to plan it with the auditors and normally you come together and you have witnesses to look you over the shoulder when you create the key and make sure that the key is created on an HSM. This is quite a lot of effort. And that's why we thought there should be a better solution to that. So what are the requirements for a solution? So what you want to is to prove that the key is created in an HSM and you want to prove all the attributes and flags and parameters this key has. What would be nice to have is the destiny that you can do it over and over again and not only at creation, but you're flexible with the timing of the proof and that it doesn't need human interaction and that it's also machine verifiable. So then the whole organization of people coming together will be obsolete. Especially now with Corona, it's nice to have. So in the key attestation, we have the root key that has these attributes. You have a key name, the public key. You have the flags that it's not imported, that it has never been extracted, that it's indestructible. Optionally, you also have the smart key attribute policies. Via the application, you have the possibility, either through the Java API or the REST API, to get the attestation. Then you get an XML with all the attributes and it's signed with the attestation key out of our HSM. You get a whole certificate chain to validate the signature and to make sure there is no man in the middle. If you want to have more details how that works, there is another video about audit topics. So additionally, what you want to do is you also want to have proof of the environment, so of the logs or of the config. And for that, we also make an export that is signed. And this is done via the management interface. So we always have three different management interfaces: the UI on the device itself, the console connected locally to the device, and the remote management Decanus. Now we talk to a different concept, and that's the control of the root key itself. So instead of just controlling the device or controlling the partition, you would want to have complete control over the key itself, what it is allowed to sign. We have the smart key attributes where you can onboard a policy onto the key and say, how many people do you need in order to use the key? And you can have different groups and different quorums and combine them. And these people will need to have their authorization keys. And Securosys doesn't care where these keys are. So it could be on a smartphone, it could be on a smart card, it could be on a desktop application. The main point is that the authorization are keys, where you have a public key or the certificate that you onboard. And it also doesn't have to be the same algorithm, because potentially the root key is much larger than the possibilities on a smart card. Additionally, we have optionally created a workflow engine, because this authorization in real life, you don't want to do at the same time. Also, if you think about the ADAS use case where you need to have three of the board members, you will not get the approval simultaneously. So one gives an approval today, another guy tomorrow. So you need to collect all these authorizations, and the TSP workflow engine takes that over. It's optional to use that. You could also collect it yourself and just use the Java API, but it's easier to integrate. And the TSP itself has a REST API. Additionally, if you want to have some automated approvals based on some compliance filter, some checklist, you can also automate that with our TE. There is another video how the TE works. I thank you for your attention, and these are all the features we have to support you to control your PKI keys. Thank you.